My name's Abby. I work for Broward County Sea Turtle Conservation Program, and I'm here to talk to you about my favorite sea turtle, Kemp's Ridley. So Kemp Ridleys are more commonly found in the Gulf of Mexico, but they also enjoy swimming around in the warm North Atlantic water. So Kemp Ridleys, they get to about 75 to 100 pounds max. That's about a little over 2 feet in size. They really like munching on crabs and tunicates, so they usually stick to the bottom of the ocean and eat a lot of those bottom dwellers. This species of sea turtle most commonly nests in the northern Mexico area. They're also found in Texas, and those numbers are actually increasing, which is really cool. But what's even cooler is that Kemp's Ridleys, when they do nest, they come in these mass quantities. So you have thousands of females coming on shore, and they all nest at the same time during the day. And that's what we call an arapaima. Some fun facts about my favorite sea turtle, Kemp's Ridley, is that they are the smallest species of sea turtle that we have. So they only get to be about the size of a large dog. And also their shell or their carapace is about as long as it is wide. Kemp's Ridleys are endangered currently. So to be endangered means that they face a really high risk of becoming extinct. So their population is really close to being wiped off the face of the earth. And this is due to a few reasons. All of them are because of humans. So humans have over-harvested them, they've knocked off a lot of the population from overfishing and stuff, and a big one is pollution. Pollution causes a lot of issues for sea turtle populations because of ingesting pollution getting in the way of their nesting habitat, a lot of things like that. So that's why it's important for programs like ours to monitor these populations so that we can keep an eye on them and see if they're getting better or getting worse. There's a lot that you can do to help this species. There's a lot that you can do to help all sea turtle species. Things like buying reusable bags at the grocery store instead of using the plastic ones. Don't get plastic straws, get reusable straws instead. If you want to buy seafood, make sure it's from a sustainable fisheries, and definitely, definitely pick up your trash. You may think that you don't have a big impact on these animals, but you do, and you can make a big change.